it is a big question that comes to every couple's mind, that when to go for IVF, when the IVF word should be said, okay, yes, we should go for IVF. So like seeing a IVF specialist is equivalent, many patients think that it is equivalent to going to see a shrink. Like when you have a mental disorder, people don't try to talk about mental disorders. So it is equivalent that people don't try to talk about their infertility issues also. But it's a big taboo. And all patients should see us as early as possible. So now coming to the point that when should you take the switch from a normal, like the normal treatment that you're taking from a gynecologist, or normally you're getting an IUI is done and then should switch to IVF. So first and foremost, for all couples, there are some basic indications for IVF. There are clear-cut indications. One is the male factor. So if you have got severe OATS, means severe oligoastenoteratozoospermia, in your husband, or if the male partner is watching directly, then you should definitely go for a ICSI cycle. Because in all patients who have got severe disorder of sperm, it is not going to be cured by antioxidants or any medications that we are going to give you. Secondly, all patients who are having azoospermia, means they don't have any sperms in the semen, all these patients also need an IVF cycle. Because in those patients, we take out sperm from their testes and we do the ICSI with TESA procedure, or if required, we also go for micro TZ in patients in whom in TESA we are not able to get sperms. So these are some clear-cut indications in male factor for doing an IVF cycle. Not coming to females, if you have a blocked fallopian tube, because the fallopian tube is very important and it carries your eggs, and here only the sperm meets the eggs and further it transports it into the womb. So in the fallopian tube, if the fallopian tube is blocked, then obviously you can't do anything. So these kind of patients should see us as soon as possible, because there is no cure for it. If we go and try to do a laparoscopy also, in very few cases only the tubes open and the tubes are functional, because the tubes might open but they are not functional because all the cilia is gone. Thirdly, in patients who are having problem with ovulation, means problem with egg formation or ovulation, they also need our support, and they are able to attain motherhood through slight support of IVF. Fourthly, in patients who are having problems with the uterus, that is the thin endometrium lining, that is also the biggest problem that we face in IVF cycles also. In those patients also, we do a frozen cycle and we try to make pregnant and we try to focus on the endometrial lining separately. So all those patients who are having thin endometrial lining, they also need to go for IVF support, because if they are going to go for natural cycle, they are not able to attain that endometrial lining in the same cycle when we are making the oocyte and the endometrium. So these patients are some gross patients who need our IVF support. Fourthly, all patients who are having premature ovarian failure. Premature ovarian failure is the biggest problem which is cropping up in today's society because of the increased stress levels in females also these days. So premature ovarian failure patients, and like what you say that we can't do anything much for them, we have to go for donor oocytes with them. And so subsequently, we have to plan an IVF cycle. And fourthly, also we have patients who have to opt for surrogacy. But it's surrogacy, you should not feel bad about doing a surrogacy, because after all, you are able to become a mother through a surrogacy process also. So, and some patients are also there who are having unexplained infertility, means they are having no problem, but still they have not been able to become pregnant. So these patients also need to see us, and we do an IVF cycle for them. We are also doing IVF cycles for patients with many autoimmune disorders, who are able to not conceive, because we suppress their bodies, make the embryos and put it back in them. And some patients who have got recurrent IUI failures or recurrent miscarriages also, these patients also we go for PGS and we can do IVF cycle in them so that a healthy baby is transferred in their womb. Have a good day.